Hey, what's up, team? It's Sherman here from Geek Psychology. This video is on the Scarlet Witch as an INFP, and let me go through how I'm going to go through this video, because it's going to be a little different than the other ones before. I think what needs to happen is we need to have an understanding of the Scarlet Witch's past and her story. It's all over the place. which kind of rings true for probably a lot of INFPs. And there's a lot of tragedy and stuff in it too. And then after that, I'm going to explain the function stack, what that is, how that kind of fits into this whole thing, and then explain how the cognitive functions are working within her mental wiring, within her function stack. And I'll be doing that through comparing them in the spectrums. So like her strongest function and her weakest function and how they're connected and how they kind of tell her story. And as well as her auxiliary supporting style and the one that she kind of runs to stay within her introverted realm. Okay, so let me get into the background here. I have my MacBook over here, so I'm going to be looking over here quite a bit because I don't want to miss anything. So first of all, how do I do this? Okay, so her mom and her dad had a child, not her, okay, before. Their child died. Her dad went nuts and killed a bunch of people. By the way, her dad is Magneto. There's been a lot of like retcon and the story has changed a bit, but at this point, in her story and in how I'm going through this flow, her father is Magneto. So her mom is freaked out. Obviously, because she's like, who is this man that's killed a bunch of people? So she runs away to Wundagore, and this is where she has the twins, Pietro and Wanda. And after she has her babies, her mom is afraid that Magneto is going to find them or find her, and bad stuff will happen, so she runs away. And so now Wanda and Pietro are just born. They have no family. They were kind of raised a little bit by a humanoid cow, Bova. And also, by the way, she has been chosen as the vessel for K'thon, an elder god. So there's a lot going on already. She and her brother were adopted by the Maximoff family in a nearby village, and her dad stole some bread to feed his family, that awful, awful man. And so he's chased out of the town with his family by the townspeople, and the townspeople set fire to the town and killed her adoptive mother. And her dad vanished, and so they're young, they're lost in the woods, and they're exploring Europe and things like that, and repressing their tragic memories. Then they go to a new town, and Wanda accidentally, I guess, started a fire when trying to save a child. So the townspeople are like, they're in cahoots with the devil. These two are bad. They need to be killed, and they get all pissed off. And then Magneto comes in, who they don't know are connected. Nobody knows. Magneto comes in and saves them. At this point, Wanda has no real control over her abilities, which is why they accidentally happened. Okay, so then they join the Brotherhood of Evil Mutants, and they do bad things, a lot of bad things, And eventually, the twins are like, okay, we've repaid our debt to Magneto for saving us. We're done. We're out of here. And they join the Avengers with Hawkeye, who was also a bad guy before. So they're in the Avengers. That's great. They're doing good stuff. The Avengers group expands, and Vision comes in. And Vision is an android, basically. And they fall in love. Wanda and Vision fall in love. And Hawkeye and her brother, Quicksilver, Pietro, are against this. Hawkeye likes Wanda. Pietro is like, this is, you gotta be with a human. This is weird. And, but they're in love and they can't have children, but she does it through immaculate conception using her magical powers. So, kind of throughout her time in the Avengers, she gets training through Agatha Harkness to control her powers. She's a witch, so Scarlet Witch is learning how to control her abilities a lot more. And she gets better at it. She actually kind of gets some higher roles within the Avengers. I think at one point she was leading it as Cap was out of the picture. But anyway, she learns how to control her powers for good. She can heal people, she can put out protective shields. She can also do some more bad stuff, like creating sickness within other people. I'll talk about her abilities later on in the video, but for now we gotta get through this background. And then her children die. So she's furious, of course, and she kills Vision, she kills Hawkeye, she almost kills Ant-Man, but her future self comes back to save him. I told you, this stuff is crazy. And then she's subdued by Doctor Strange and INTJ, and she's taken away to safety by Magneto. And at this point, the Avengers and the X-Men are teaming up to decide what to do, because Wanda, Scarlet Witch, is too powerful and out of control, and she's going through a lot of stuff. So what do we do with her? Do we kill her? How do we control her? So as they're deciding that, her brother Pietro Quicksilver catches wind of that and suggests to her that she creates an alternate reality, which she can do, where everybody kind of gets their wish. And she does this, everybody's happy for a while until some mutants get their memory back. Wolverine was one of them, I believe. And now, and Magneto too. And now everyone's pissed. Magneto hears that it was Quicksilver's idea to do this, so he kills Quicksilver. Obviously, she doesn't like that. She resurrects Quicksilver, which is another thing that she can do. And she's even more pissed at everybody and her father, or who she thinks is her father. And in return, she depowers 90% of the mutant population by just whispering, "No more mutants." So this is pretty ridiculous, right? And then she goes and she retires to Wundagore. Like, I'm done. I don't want to be here anymore. And she puts herself in some other place. And that is, I want to say that's a look at the INFP's world. Like, we latch on to all of these kind of negative experiences that have happened in our lives, and we make a big deal about a lot of them. We might not show it, but deep down in here and in here, we are like all over the place until we become healthier and we really figure out what we stand for and how our values are actually kind of shaping our reality and the reality around us. So it's very important to take those bad experiences and some of the good ones and kind of just use it in a positive way as much as you can. it's difficult sometimes, I understand, but it's very important. Okay, so we have the background taken care of. Now let me explain a little bit how I'm going to talk about her abilities and how this relates to the cognitive functions. So first, it's important to understand the cognitive function stack of the INFP. So this means that introverted feeling is the dominant function. This is your primary kind of way of dealing with the world. And then the auxiliary function is extroverted intuition. It's kind of the supporting way that hopefully kind of gets INFPs out of their shell and lets them deal with the objective world. After that, you have the tertiary function, which is lower in kind of development. This is introverted sensing. It's kind of where we go when we try to defend our introverted mindset and we think the outer world is all bad and stuff like that. This kind of justifies that. It's like, yeah, this is all that information that you need to believe that the outer world is always the problem. And it keeps you locked in your brain, in your introverted side. And then after that, you have the inferior function. The inferior function is extroverted thinking, which is the polar opposite of introverted feeling. So it's an extroverted function that's connected to how we understand the world, but it's kind of all that suppressed side, the stuff that we don't look at. And I'll explain what those functions are a little bit more now, while talking about Wanda Scarlet Witch and her story and some of her abilities. But I'm going to do this in a little different way than I've done before. I'm going to talk about it within the polarities, okay? The dichotomies of her dominant function and her inferior function first, and then her auxiliary function and her tertiary function. If this doesn't really make sense to you right now, that's okay. Just kind of go with it and keep open, and I'll hopefully explain it all so that it makes sense. So, first of all, we have introverted feeling, the dominant function, the compulsion state, and extroverted thinking, the inferior and aspirational function. So it's her strength and her weakness, basically. These are both judging functions. They are the ones that help, well, that you use to make decisions, basically. Tell you what you should do in a situation. Introverted feeling is basically about seeking identity. It's about exploring and refining your personal values and tastes and beliefs. And through that, emotions as well. Kind of understanding all the shades of sadness and happiness and, you know, all that kind of stuff. And it's a decision-making function that's internally held, and it's about these deep values, these intense values. Like, this is who I am as a person. This is who I'm not. And this is who humans should be and who they should not be. So it's very intense and very structured through experience. If you don't have a lot of experience in the outer world, it's not going to be very structured. And so this kind of has a lot to do with her story. And she's always like thrown in the world and doesn't really have a sense of who she is. She's constantly searching for her place in the world. So that's a mix of introverted feeling and extroverted thinking, which I'll talk about in a second. And she also, INFPs specifically, anthropomorphize a lot, which is attributing human qualities to objects and animals and things like that. And this was kind of something that hit me when I was like, oh yeah, she's in love with an android. Like, Vision is not a full human, but of course it would be an INFP to be like, oh yeah, I love this person, right? And to attach really deep values and yourself fully and merge into that other person or object or animal, whatever it is. This isn't really connected to the Scarlet Witch, but introverted feeling kind of, us introverted feeling dominants have this holistic listening state that Dario Nardi talks about, where we just kind of stop and let the other person project their thoughts and feelings and ideas, and we kind of just help them go through their state by listening to them and kind of slowly coaching them through it. Because we have a lot of experience in thinking about our emotions and our values and things like that, because that's where we focus most of our mental energy. Okay, now going on to extroverted thinking. Okay, this is on the other side. This is her weakness. We'll get into her actual powers in a second, but extroverted thinking is organizing effectively the outer world. So it's, you can see how it's opposite, right? It's not feelings, it's not internally held values, it's the outer world and what works. Like, how do you get from point A to point B based on these kind of systems and the empirical evidence? And it's evidence-based decision-making, basically. And it's based on those objective measures, like what do the numbers tell us? What do the results tell us? Is this working? Is it not working? Okay, we need to shift the world and the systems that we're using to get to our goal. So it's very different. It tries to measure, plan, construct, things like that. Use reliable methods and focus on structure. So this is what I was talking about Wanda constantly searching for herself within this universe that is out of her control. And also the constant rewriting of her story, I felt really fit as an inferior extroverted thinking. Like, she's looking, she's searching, she's trying to be her true, authentic self, and then things just get rewritten and she's like, well, I don't know anymore. Like, that's a meta perspective of the whole thing, but still, it felt very real for me. Like, sometimes things just happen and you're like, okay, gotta reassess, you know, who I am and where I'm going and all that stuff. Also, Magneto is an ENTJ, I believe. So extroverted thinking, and that is, you know, kind of represented within her dislike for how he's being this kind of cold, ruthless, controlling bad guy. And also introverted feelers, us INFPs, ISFPs, usually have this desire, and this is with anybody, but a desire to go and follow somebody and connect to somebody who is a dominant or auxiliary user of our inferior function. So somebody who uses extroverted thinking, we connect to them because it feels like, you know, they're giving us what we need to be full and have control of the outer world. Definitely very true from my experience. It gives us a grounded sense of objective reality that we struggle to find ourselves. And I also thought that her saying, you know, all this bad stuff's happening, people are trying to kill her, and then she's just like, no more mutants. Right with that, I felt that it was her way of forcing everybody in the outer world to feel how helpless and how, like, out of control she feels, without actually, like, hurting them and killing them and things like that. Just kind of a passive-aggressive, depowering, like, this is where I am. And I think I do that sometimes when I'm in my bad states, too. It's just like, okay, you want to know how I'm feeling right now? And then you just kind of explode with it. This is how I'm feeling. That's why I don't express it a lot. And then you go back into your mind. One thing to remember throughout this is that she's not healthy, you know, and how could she be? She's lost her mother more times than she can remember, because she actually can't remember when she lost her first mother, her real mother. And she's like, she's a vessel for K'thon, an elder god. Also, K'thon means, actually, I'll explain that in a second. Whoop, going back. All right. I'll explain that in this next part with extroverted intuition. So now we're going to look at extroverted intuition and introverted sensing. These are perceiving functions. If she were to focus more on her auxiliary function of extroverted intuition, she would be in more control, actually. She would be stronger. But she has to use it properly. She has to use it as a way to shore up those weaknesses of only having one perspective of the world. So it would give her other different viewpoints, basically. And extroverted intuition is kind of looking at and exploring possibilities. It's energetic exploration of ideas and possibilities by tapping into different contexts and kind of like pinging different ideas, looking for connections and, you know, novel ways of understanding it. It's generalized, it's broad, it's abstract, it's not connected to the real reality. It's thinking of the ideas that come from that. And it's more present and future focused, whereas introverted feeling is past and, I guess, present focused. You know, how did my past turn me into who I am, and everything that happened in the past, like, what does that mean for me and who I am as a person, and what should I be doing right now based on how I've felt about experiences in the past? So for the keys to understanding the Scarlet Witch, as well as the INFP, her abilities, they have also kind of been changed a bit, but she has reality-disrupting hex spheres that alter the probability of things happening. So if she uses it over here, like, a gas main might explode. It has a chance of exploding. Over here, like, it could suck out all the oxygen, apparently. Like, there's just kind of a randomness to her abilities. And a lot of them focus on that bad luck probability. Like, something bad will happen now if I use my ability over here. This is also short range, and it has to be in line of sight, which I thought was kind of funny, because extroverted intuition is not long range. It's not introverted intuition. It's not looking for, like, the deep down connected meanings of things. It's just like, hey, what if this? What if this? What if this? Just bouncing around. So it's more short range. And early on, when she was younger and still not really sure of her abilities, the hexes that she used were largely subconscious and out of her control. This is how she set fire to that town, and how some bad things happened throughout her growing stages. And this is something that I think INFPs can really relate to as well, as like, when we're younger, we don't know who we are, but we're constantly searching for our values and morals and things like that, experiencing the good and the bad of life and trying to figure out where we fall within that. And it's kind of out of our control. It's just, we're always trying to understand it, and we need that connection to extroverted intuition in order to really make sense of it. We got to get out of ourselves, basically. And she eventually learned to focus her hexes with gestures, which is an extroverted way of dealing with the world, right? It's not in her head anymore. It's using a gesture. She's like swirling around and stuff in order to focus her internal thoughts and feelings outside of herself. And now, actually, with When she's overextended as well, the hexes can backfire and cause bad luck to herself and her team and things like that. Which, I mean, that happens with a lot of us when we are too trapped in our dominant function, and then we're trying to figure out what to do, and we just get overwhelmed, and then we use our auxiliary function for bad instead of good. Kind of beyond the scale of this video, as it's already getting a little long, but not too much more. Also, she now has chaos magic. This has kind of been rewritten into her to explain like why things seem so powerful and not quite fitting within that possibility disrupting field of the hex spheres and whatnot. And this chaos magic is from K'thon, the Elder God, and K'thon means subterranean. So her powers come from making real what's hidden under the surface. When I had that realization, I was like, oh my god. You know, introverted feelers need to get out. They need to make real and extrovert what is going on under the surface. Or they're just going to be stuck in there and they're not going to be able to control their powers. And extroverted intuition lets her see the new possibilities for positive action, which I said through her kind of healing and protective shields and things like that. The more she connects to it, the better she's going to be at it. For all of us. And now the opposite of the, on the spectrum of that, is introverted sensing. So this is her tertiary function. So it's kind of like that 10-year-old cognitive process. Not quite as skilled, but it's easy to relate to because it's within the same reality. It's introverted if you're an introvert, it's extroverted if you're an extrovert. So this is more, introverted sensing is the opposite of that, right? So it's about supporting traditions. It's about focusing on recovering specific details and events and information, sensory-based information from your past, and comparing it to what's going on right now. It's not abstract. It's as concrete as you can be within the introverted world, which is why it comes out as data and facts and stuff instead of real things, real senses like heat and smell. Like, it's a little bit different. This is also specialized, it's focused, it's, like I said, tangible, and this is where a lot of her training with Agatha, I think, kind of gravitated towards. Like, being trained in a specific thing, specializing in using her abilities, feels like a very introverted sensing thing. If you watch the Captain America video, this will make more sense with that too. And yeah, it's kind of like an anchor to her past as well. Even more to kind of like accentuate her introverted feelings anchor. So for her, the training by Agatha was helpful, but it wasn't quite enough. This is kind of showing that tertiary function. It's just, it's good, but you can't always rely on it. It's just not enough. What she needs to do is get real experience using her abilities a lot more. Also, the Scarlet Witch has been trained in basic sorcery techniques. She lacks the specialized mystic training required to fully control her power. So the more she gets out and uses her abilities, the more training she's going to be able to have, and the more she's going to be able to control herself. This also comes into a little deeper concept of a loop. Introverted feeling and introverted sensing loop. Being stuck in your internal realm without expressing yourself, without going out there. And it's constant reliving of these traumatic experiences that have happened in her past with no perceived way of dealing with them. And so the buildup of too much introversion is when her psyche lashes out and she kind of goes crazy and she kills Vision and Hawkeye and just goes nutty because she's stuck too much within her introverted realm. She needs to get healthy ways of using her abilities, like healing people. She can do that. Oh, she can resurrect people too. Which she did. She resurrected her brother and I believe Vision and Hawkeye too. Why didn't she do that with her children? I don't really know. But, you know, more experience with that would help her understand her actual control of the outer world, if that's what she wants to do, or just the kind of objective reality of like, wow, that's something, can't really do too much about. Obviously, dealing with the death of a child is going to be traumatic. I understand that. Don't wish that on anybody, but, you know, in this fantasy realm, she could do that, right? They had like some shards of a demon in them and stuff too. More craziness. Also, she, you know, this loop connects to going back into her past, like through time traveling. I do that all the time. I time travel all the time. You know, just constantly going back into my past and trying and reliving it for the good or the bad. Lately, I'm, you know, you gotta focus on the good, but it doesn't always happen. Also, her returning to Wundagore at the end of this whole, like, background that I explained, that's her going back to her past and, like, closing up even more. Obviously, she doesn't want to die, so that's part of the reason, but you're not gonna die. She's super strong. She's straight. Also, let's see, forfeits the external reality and returns to her inner world. So, a couple more points before we finish this video here. Many INFPs believe in karma and the idea that, you know, when something good happens, they're gonna have to repay that debt with something bad. And I think that's kind of shown through a lot of her story. Like, she's adopted. That's great. Well, first she's born. Yay, that's great. And then bad stuff happens. And then she's adopted, and then bad stuff happens, right? And then she finds a town, she saves a child, oh, she burns down the town, and now people want to kill her. Bad stuff. Oh, she's saved by Magneto. Great. Oh, he's an asshole. He's a bad guy trying to destroy the world. Bad stuff. You know, again and again, she gets married. Great. She can't have a child. Oh. Immaculate conception. Great. Her children die. Oh. It's just back and forth. And yeah, I related to that. Although I try to keep optimistic, you know, it's in there, that idea. Also, let's see, she feels responsible for hidden motives and intentions, even if her behavior exceeds people's expectations. I think this is something all INFPs feel, is like, we have these negative thoughts, so we must be flawed in some way. We must have this problem about us. But it's not true, you know? Like, what we do to help other people and to be this form of, like, stability, emotional stability, and a way of helping other people work through their problems and things like that and understand themselves at a deeper level. This is a superpower that we have. And sometimes we have, you know, negative thoughts and stuff like that, but our intentions are almost always, hopefully, in the right. At least within our own perspective. Which means we need to get more into that auxiliary function and experience the outer world of chaos and probabilities in order to really understand what we can do within the world. So, real quick, last recap, introverted feeling, her conflicted past, possessed by and being a vessel for an elder god, and in love with a robot. I still find that hilarious. Extroverted intuition, chaos magic, witchcraft, hexes, just random probability, and also the growth state where her power can be shown in the outer world. Introverted sensing, this training in sorcery, also in hand-in-hand combat, melee up close. And that introverted sensing loop within her tertiary and dominant function. And extroverted thinking, like the whole rewriting and still searching for her place within the world, within the universe. And her hate for like the larger corrupt systems. Okay. So if you made it this far, thank you very much for watching. I hope it was informative. If you're an INFP, let me know. Let me know what kind of rang true for you. If you're not an INFP, then comment. Still, ask questions. Whatever you gotta say, say it. Critiques are good too. And that's it. Thank you very much for watching. Keep up the lifelong questing, and good luck. Have fun. Peace.